The District Line serves 60 stations stretching from Upminster in the east to Wimbledon, Richmond and Ealing in the west. Between 1980 and 2017, for 37 years, it was operated using D-stock type trains, until they, like other subsurface underground lines, were replaced by the more modern S-stock. At the beginning of 2017, as the last few units were still operating on the network, we followed driver instructor Frank Miller for the day to ask about his thoughts on the old stock and discuss the transition to the new. This is the last of the D stock. Upminster is one of four places on the District Line where drivers book on. The facility is here, Calverley House, where there's also a simulator for the new S-stock trains, which we'll take a look at later. But first, we joined driver instructor Frank Miller as he took out a train to Richmond. Frank's been on the District Line now for 15 years.
My service calling at all stations to Richmond. This train's now ready to depart. Minor doors, please. Minor closing doors.
Frank's been driving the District Line D-stock since around the year 2000.
I've been driving these trains since 14, 15 years, something like that. I was quite fortunate in 2001 to be taken on as a direct train operator, so I didn't have to go through stations or be a guard or anything. Just straight off the street, as they say. They call us DROPS, it stands for Direct Recruit Train Operator. And that was at Parsons Green and then Earls Court, and then I got transferred to Upminster, which is a lot closer to home. And been an instructor as well for about 8 or 9 years, which makes the job a lot more interesting and a bit more rewarding. We're training new people up, people coming from stations, getting quite a big pay rise to become train operators. So I enjoy that. It helps keep your knowledge live and you've got someone to talk to, so it's far more sociable being an instructor. I drove C-stocks at Earls Court and Parsons Green. Quite missed them really. They were taken out of service a couple of years ago and they were the first trains on the District Line to be replaced by S-stocks. They had separate train line air and main line air. They were quite a lot more difficult, complicated on defect handling. The TBC, we had to press it down, to traction brake control, you had to press it down quite hard and turn it that way. And they're just much older trains, 1969, 1977 they were. These are 1978s.
The old D-stock is revered by a lot of the train operators, as we sense early on that Frank will miss them. Overall, he says, they have character.
Character's a good word for it, yeah. They're more comfortable, it seems. But the actual trains, they are more clunky. They're less sophisticated than the S-stocks, clearly. But they're very, very reliable. They're the most reliable train ever on London Underground to date. So from a driver's point of view, being as we have to fix them when they go wrong, the fact that D-stocks are so reliable makes them quite desirable. I personally shall miss D-stocks. I've had good experiences with them.
So what's the more robust train, the D-stock or the S-stock?
You get little glitches with all trains. They all contain a lot of electronics. Clearly the S-stock contains even more, and it's quite a harsh environment. You've got fluctuations in temperature, you've got damp conditions, especially in the winter, in the mornings, you're getting bashed around on the rails, and clearly things do occasionally go wrong. A lot of defects can be remedied by just shutting the train down, taking the control keys out, and starting again from scratch. That quite often clears defects. Probably even more so with the S-stocks, because it's a bit like a laptop computer, so very similar to a computer. If you shut it down and reopen it again, you can quite often get rid of little faults that might have been on there. These are a lot more basic, but there's less to go wrong, and most reliable train ever.
But do the passengers like the new trains?
The customers have given a very good reception to the S-Dock, as far as I know, from my own personal talking to them, but mainly because of the air conditioning in the back. Because obviously we started getting these trains, I think, in February, and so they've had them through the summer, and aircon for passengers, customers, has been something we haven't been able to give them before. Yeah, they've definitely welcomed that. And clearly the increased capacity of the S-Dock is going to be welcome, even if they might be unconscious of it. More people can fit on them, so that's got to be a good thing from their point of view.
The D-Stock has a feature common on old tube stock called the weak field flag, used to regulate a train's acceleration and top speed.
At the moment, we're running as we should do with a particular weak field flag up, which restricts the motors to 40 miles an hour. So you get up to 40 miles an hour and then the motors will drop out. It doesn't mean that you can't roll a little bit faster than 40 on these. It doesn't stop it going over 40, but it stops it motoring over 40. So. But if you have the other flag up, the coasting flag, then these can get up to around 50. This is a category A platform, which basically means that if for any reason we can't see a clear view in the monitors of the entire side of the train and the platform, then we need to get someone to assist us with departing the platform. If it's category B, we can look out of the cab door and carry on. In actual fact, I can see they're okay. This is a notoriously difficult platform, Bromley by Bar on the westbound, where you can get issues with sunlight. Just make sure I've got a pilot light. That's all good. Pilot light is called a pilot light because it looks like a pilot light on a boiler or a gas heater. It's just a little blue light up here, and it tells us that all the doors are correctly closed on the whole of the train. So door closed visual is its correct name. If that one is hard to see, which it can be in bright circumstances, there is another one in a little glass panel here and another one on the other side in the same place.
Victoria, the best named station on the network, it's time to look at some of the pre-programmed announcements.
Yeah, we can use this panel here to send pre-recorded messages if you like. So, excuse me, sorry, the radio. If we do, if you press F1, then we can press any one of these numbers and it'll come up with different message. 3 is to mind the doors, please.
We're running alongside the westbound Piccadilly line here, but Frank points out the protection on the eastbound tracks which stop District Line trains going into the Piccadilly line tunnels by mistake.
So on the next gantry there, you can see some hoops hanging down above the Piccadilly line. If we were to go up there, we'd break those hoops off and that would cause all the signals in the area to return to danger and thus prevent us from going down the Piccadilly line tube past Barons Court.
There's also a fact about the District Line at Gloucester Road, which we bet you didn't know.
Gloucester Road on the westbound, it's the only place where, with the D-Stocks, we actually put the train slightly into the tunnel mouth because it's such a short platform, just to get the rear doors lined up. So the train's occupying the entire length of the platform now, and we've just got these two monitors on the inside of the tunnel wall. Barons Court westbound here is one place where we've got a few options from the station starter. Instead of getting a straight Greens, which we've now got to go to Hammersmith like we normally do, we could have harbour lights at 45 degrees. That would take us onto the Piccadilly line, otherwise called the Fast Line, and we could take that all the way up to Acton Town just in case there was a blockage or a problem on the District Line, and we are trained to be able to do that move. We can also get harbour lights at 90 degrees. That will take us into Barons Court sidings, which is the beginning of a reverse move. I will miss the D stocks. I miss the C stocks, and yeah, of course you miss them. These are very comfortable and very reliable, and I'm completely at home with them. And it's going to take a long while to achieve that same level of comfort with the S-Stock, I think, that level of familiarity. There's still a slightly out of your comfort zone thing with S-Stocks when things go wrong. On these trains, having driven them for so long, and some of my colleagues have driven them for much, much longer, there's a kind of, you've seen most of the things that it can throw at you, so you're that much more relaxed when things do start to go wrong, passenger alarms, defects, that sort of thing. But on the S-Stocks, although we've driven them up and down and normal driving is becoming fairly familiar, it's going to be a long while before we've had all the experiences on them that we've had on these trains. And in the meanwhile, it's a little bit out of your comfort zone. Coming to Turn and Green now on the westbound, which is where we need to decide whether we're going to go to Ealing Broadway or to Richmond. As we're going to Richmond today, we want to get Harbour Lights to the left when the signal eventually clears. That'll take us to Gunnersbury, whereas a straight green would take us to Chiswick Park and on to Ealing Broadway. Got the correct signal now.
At Richmond, it's the end of the line, and it's time to shut down and change trains.
Two red lights.
Frank has a small amount of turnaround time here before he heads back east, hopefully without any pigeons on board, but this time he's driving one of the new S-Stock trains. On board the new train, Frank talks about some of the differences between the two trains from a driver's perspective.
We've got in-cab monitors. They're pretty good. With the conventional monitors, we quite often get problems with sunlight issues and shadows and things, whereas the in-cab monitors are pretty good. The other thing that's important, which is what I'm concentrating on now, is that we have to stop in different positions. And while we're driving two different stocks, that has caught a few people out who are stopping D stocks on S stop marks and S stops on D stop marks. It's almost inevitable while we've got both stocks running.
On the new S stock, the controller is also now operated by the left hand.
Obviously, different people would be affected more by that than others. I'm left handed anyway. I used to drive the D stocks with my left hand and the C stocks, so I haven't had an issue with that personally. So no, but I think some people have. It's fairly light mover, so it's not a heavy thing to have to do. The further forward you go, the faster it will go. In the middle, you've got off and release like you have on a D-stock, and then if you pull the handle backwards, you've got an increasingly powerful brake. The brakes are much better, I've got to say, than a D-stock, especially in the wet. You've got a quite sophisticated anti-lock braking system, so they're much less likely to slide. The computer takes over and stops them pretty well in the wet, I must say. And the acceleration's quite a lot smoother as well.
We pass back through the city and head out east again. Back at Upminster Depot, Frank takes us to go and see the S-Stock simulator, but not before we've had a quick detour around the back of the building to see the garden. That's right, a garden. Tended by TfL staff, it contains railway paraphernalia as well as several lovely tribute plaques to former members of railway staff. Here, there's a mock-up of a tube train and track with ballast where train operators practice what to do if they need to detrain their passengers.
It simulates a detrainment because sometimes we have to get passengers off of trains for various reasons and walk them out. And that would be through the front door of the train. And there's a special ladder that locks into these receptacles here and then drops down and provides a stairwell to allow passengers to get off the front of the train. And it's a good thing to be able to practice. So that's the whole purpose of this room, really, is just to simulate detrainments and how to get the ladder out.
Then, in the room next door, is the S-Stock simulator itself.
Signal's off on the left. That's a shunt signal. You asked what shunt signal was when we were in the garden. That's a shunt signal at danger on the right-hand side. Well, there's two there, in fact. The one on the left, being at a 45-degree angle, has cleared, so we're allowed to go past that. So, got a pilot light to say all the doors are closed, and we can just move off.
And just how good is the simulator?
It's as good as it can be without having some sort of associated movement. Some people find it makes them feel a little bit travel sick because your body can see that it's moving, but there's no associated sort of kinetic movement. So some people find that upsets them a little bit. It's kind of reverse travel sickness, if you like, where you are moving and you can't see that you're moving. Whereas this, you can see you're moving and your body thinks you're not. The geography here is completely as it is when you're actually out there. Another thing with the fact the train doesn't actually move is it's a little bit difficult on a simulator to stop accurately, because obviously on a train, if you've been driving for 20, 30 years plus, as some of our drivers have, the feeling of stopping is a huge help in an accurate stopping in exactly the right place. So the fact there's no movement does make it a little bit difficult because you think nothing's happening when you put the brakes on. They're acknowledging us. There we go, westbound towards Upminster Bridge.
The very last passenger trip for a D-Stock train ran on Friday, the 21st of April 2017, travelling between Upminster and Richmond for a few trips before making one final run down to Ealing Broadway, where it then went into the depot. Many people came out to ride it on its last day.
I hope you've enjoyed your day. I'll be approaching Ealing Broadway shortly, but it's been a pleasure to have you all aboard.
And we've made a separate video all about it if you follow the link. This was the last of the D-Stocks.